Good morning, backyard kids. Merry Christmas. It's been a wonderful month celebrating Christmas, celebrating Jesus, which was God's greatest gift. Now you may wonder why I'm wishing you a Merry Christmas when we know that Christmas was yesterday. But as Christians, God's gift of Jesus to us is something that we should and we do celebrate every day. So our last Christmas story this month begins with a group of wise men that were living far to the east of Jerusalem at the time that Jesus was born. They came looking for Jesus, following a star that they had read about in Scripture. They knew that the star would be a sign of a new king over God's people. So when the wise men saw that star, they knew that they had to follow it and see where it led. So they packed up some gifts to honor the new king and set out on their journey across the desert. Eventually, the wise men reached the city of Jerusalem, and they entered the city and asked if anyone knew where to find the child that was born to be king of the Jews. Now, there was a king in the land, King Herod, and he didn't really like the sound of this new king, and he was trying to find him as well. So when he heard that the wise men had come to Jerusalem, he sent for them and asked them to go on to Bethlehem and find the child and report back to him. And he told them that he wanted to find the child as well so that he could go and worship him too. So the wise men left the palace and they continued their journey following the star. The star stopped over the place where Jesus was, and the wise men got there soon after. Mary and Joseph welcomed them in, and they bowed down in front of the baby king and then gave him the gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh that they had brought. But before the wise men left to return home, God spoke to them in a dream, and he warned them not to go back to King Herod, because King Herod only meant to bring harm to the baby. So they took a different road as they traveled back to their own country. But I want you to think about all that led up to this story. Over hundreds and hundreds of years, knowledge about the coming king was passed down to generations and then new generations of people. Because of that, these wise men knew that God had promised to send a savior and that they should follow the star that would appear in order to find him. They wanted to meet Jesus, to honor and to celebrate him. And kids, you and I can do just what the wise men did. We can take time to celebrate and to worship Jesus, not just at Christmas, but all year long. We can do that with the way that we live and the way that we show his love to others. And that's our bottom line for this week. Never stop celebrating Jesus.